Lord Jesus. What a day to be alive. Please connect with us. As you come online, just keep sharing. Stay with us. Praise Jesus. Come online, come online. Today's gonna be great. Thank you, Lord. International Christian Center Studio in Johannesburg, South Africa. I am your host, Pastor Francis Essence. Just stay with us as we kick on this part two of our message we started on Sunday. This nonsense must stop. Hallelujah. This nonsense must stop. We are ending the month of April, and we are ending this month with this pandemic. We are not entering the month of May with it at all. This nonsense must stop. The panicking all over the world is an end to it. Today is the last day in the month of April, and it's going to be the last day that you see. He said, the Egyptian you see yesterday, you see yesterday, you won't see them anymore. Hallelujah. Today is a new day. Hallelujah. Now, before we go on the telecast, tomorrow in the night, South African time, 12 midnight, we're going to have a vigil, online vigil. So please put it in your calendar and just mark it up so that you can connect with us tomorrow. Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. This nonsense must stop. Let's begin by reading the scripture, 2 Kings chapter 6. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 25.
2 Kings chapter 27.
6, yes.
From verse 25.
Yes.
And there was a great famine in Samaria.
Come on now.
And behold, they besieged it until an ass head was mm-hmm. sold for 4 score pieces of silver, and the 4th part of a calf of a doe's dung for 5 pieces of silver.
Yes.
And as the king of Israel was passing by upon the wall, there cried a woman unto him, saying, "Help, my lord, O king.
Verse 27.
Verse 27. And he said, "If the Lord do not help thee, when shall I help thee? Out of the barn floor or out of the wine press?"
Hallelujah. If the Lord did not help you, where do you think I can get help from? There was a famine in the land, because there's a prophecy that famine, everyone, people are beginning to eat their children and all that. It's so bad. And this woman ran to the king and said, oh, king, help me. Because, and the king said, if God will not help you, where will I get help from? It's shocking today to see the president of nation today, they don't see God anymore. They depend on help on medical scientists. They depend on vaccine. But this is a king say, if the Lord will not help you, where will I think I will get help from? This is a king that understand. He knew that it is only God that can rescue the nation for that quagmire, for that pestilence, for that calamity, for that hunger. But today everybody is depending on Bill Gates. Everybody depending on Melinda Gates. Everybody depending on Dr. Anthony Fauci. I call him first man. Hallelujah. No apology. Until help come from God, we can't get help anywhere. The king said, if help will not come from God, where do you, I can't produce help. I can't give you help because it is only help that will come. Until the church, until government begin to say, let's declare a day of prayers. Let the pandemic end. God will just be watching us. Because where men's strength end, God's begin. God will just for the say, okay, you continue. Until you are tired, if you will not call upon me, I will wash. It's when a season that all nations must declare prayer and fasting. Some nations are not Christian nations. It's okay, but they can pray to their God. Elijah says, say you call upon your God. I will also call upon my God. The God that answered by fire, let him be God. That is what the church will tell the government. Not depending on one verse somewhere. No apology for that. The God that answered by fire, let him be God. Because they challenged Elisha. Elisha said, well, it's well spoken. He said, let's go to Mount Carmel. Let's prove God. It's a time for the church. It's a time for believers to say, let's prove this God. If this Bible is true, if this Bible is real, let us prove it. Bible is not just a storybook, no. Bible is not just maybe a biological book somebody wrote somewhere. No, this is the word of God. Come on. Come on now. This is the word of God. When we believe this word and we stand by it, it works for us. The king said, if God will not help you, where do you think I can get help? I am not a magician. I don't believe in voodoo. Until a prophet showed up, I say it's enough, is enough. That this nonsense must stop. Why should the whole world of 7.4 billion put their hope in three people that they are waiting to produce vaccine or send vaccine to the world just to make merchandise, just to gain money, monetary value? This nonsense must stop. This nonsense. I'm telling Bill Gates and Melinda Gates and Dr. Anthony Fauci, if you will not resist what I'm doing, I will invoke the decree of Job 20. Praying against it. This nonsense must stop. Hallelujah. Thank you, my sister watching from Brazil. Well, you are blessed. Amen. We must have to reach a level whereby we can actually put this God that we have into contest with the world. Let the president of the world run to God. Let the inhabitant of every nation you are run to God. If this disease is killing people, we need to change it. Today, we're going to pray. But tomorrow, who come with me? I'm going to put this on my Facebook page. Who come with me? We're going to spend 1 hour calling upon God. On the 1st of May, this must change. Praise Jesus. Come on, praise Jesus. Now, back up with me in the book of 2 Kings. 2 Kings chapter 5. 2 Kings chapter 5. We serve a very big God. Verse 5 to 14. We serve a very big God.
2 Kings chapter 5, yes. From verse 5.
Yes.
And the king of Syria said.
And the king of Syria said. Watch, follow me. Yes.
And I will send a letter unto the king of Israel.
That's right.
And he departed and took with him 10 talents of silver.
Mm-hmm.
And 6,000 pieces of gold.
Mm-hmm.
And 10 changes of raiment.
Mm-hmm.
And he brought the letter to the king of Israel saying, now when this letter is come unto thee, behold, I have therewith sent Naaman, my servant unto thee,
yes,
that thou mayest recover him of his leprosy.
Now stop there. Now, this account of a king, another king, he sent his general, the army. the one heading their military say, go to another king. It's like, let me explain it. Maybe I don't know the nation you're watching me from. Maybe your president of your nation will give a letter to a general, a chief of army staff in your country, say, go to another our neighboring country. Tell the king that he should heal you. How come about? So because what the king was doing, that if the man, if Naaman returned with that sickness, they will face that nation with war. They were gonna conquer that nation. That was what it means. Go ahead.
Verse 7. And it came to pass,
and it came to
the king
pass.
Of Israel had read the letter.
Come on now.
That he rent his clothes and said,
Am I God?
To kill and to make alive?
Yes.
That this man does send unto me to recover a man of his leprosy?
Come on.
Wherefore consider, I pray you, and see how he seeketh a quarrel against me. And it was so, when Elisha, the man of God, had heard that the king of Israel had rent his clothes, that he sent to the king, saying, wherefore hast thou rent thy clothes?
Oh!
Let him come now to me! And he shall know.
Stop there. Elisha, you know, he was not a pastor who wanted to negotiate. Elijah was not kind of timid child of God who said, well, king, whatever you want to do, I'm out of it. Elijah said, look, King, why are you angry? Why are you afraid that you tore your clothes? In the Jewish religion, the only word for it to protest is to tear your clothes or put a sackcloth upon yourself. And when Elijah heard it, he said, oh king, let him come to me. Let him know. If there's God, we know. This is a time that pastors should rise up. If there's God in this land, we know. Elijah didn't go and hide it. We want to reach a level whereby, pastor, we can tell government, can you take us to where these people who, they are solitary people, who want to pray? Government, talk to your president, can you take us to the hospital where these people are kept? Who want to pray? We are not afraid of virus. Who want to pray? Don't bother yourself so that this lockdown will be over. Go ahead and read for me.
Verse 8 continues. Let him come now to me.
Yes.
And he shall know that there is a prophet in Israel.
Come on. Let him come to me now. Francis S.A. He will know there's a prophet. Let the president send for me now. They will know there's a prophet. Not bragging. We boast in the name of the Lord. We are not boasting because we want to say something. We boast because we know who will believe. Paul said, for I know. Not a much in that. I know. Jesus, I feel something this evening. I know whom I believe. Let them call us to come to the hospital. Let them call us to come so that we can lay hands on. We're not afraid of the virus. Let's pray. Let them know there's God. Come on, read for me. Continue.
And it was so.
Yes.
That when Elisha, the man of God, had heard that the king of Israel had rent his clothes, that he said unto the king, saying, why hast thou rent thy clothes? Let him now come unto me.
He shall know
that there is a prophet in Israel.
He shall know.
So Naaman came with his horses and with his chariot and stood at the door of the house of Elisha. And Elisha sent a messenger to him, saying, go and wash in the Jordan 7 times, and thy flesh shall come again to thee.
Now stop there. Prophet give instruction. Because prophet hear from God. When you hear from God, men will hear from you. When God speaks to you, you echo God's voice. As Jesus says, as a hear me, so they hear you. He said, how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who went about doing good, healing all that was possessed of the devil. For God is with him. Elisha said, no. Go. I am not coming to just lay hand. I am not coming to pour water on you. I am not coming to pour any oil on you. Go. Dip yourself in River Jordan. Prophet give instruction. When you follow prophet, believe what he's saying. It works for you. Hallelujah. Some of the times, people come to our church. There was a particular woman who was sick. She can't walk. And my wife told me, say, this woman cannot walk another. I said, bring her to the back. The three people, they carried her. I said, let her sit on my chair. Before, when they put her on my chair, she fell under the anointing and began to run. I said, take her, put her back on the chair. Before I finished preaching, without prayers, she was healed. Jumping up and down. That is the God we're talking about. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There's another case of one woman. She was dying because I was told they cast spell on her. She was dying. She was smelling, and they called us. Please, can you come to Pretoria so that you could pray? I said, well, I'm not going. It was on Saturday night. And I asked one of my workers, I said, go drive her down. They drove her down. On Sunday morning, I asked the ladies, she was smelling. People cannot even withstand smell. Stay on the altar. She was sitting outside of the altar. After I finished preaching, sickness jagged to hell. Prophet give instruction. When you follow it, it produces result. Hallelujah. Finish to verse 15.
Verse 10.
Yes.
And Elisha sent a messenger unto him, saying,
yes,
go and wash in Jordan 7 times, and thy flesh shall come again to thee, and thou shalt be clean.
Yes.
But Naaman was wroth and went away and said, behold, I thought he shall surely come up to me,
yes,
and stand and call on the name of the Lord his God, and strike his hand over the place and recover the leper.
The leper. Verse 12.
Are not Abana and Fafa, rivers of Damascus,
can you see mistake,
better than all the waters of Israel?
Yes.
May I not wash in them and be clean?
Mm-hmm.
So he turned and went away in rage.
Mm-hmm.
And his servants came near and spake unto him and said, my father, if the prophet had bid thee do some great thing, wouldest thou not have done it? How much rather when he said to thee, wash and be clean? Then went he down and dipped himself 7 times in Jordan.
7 times is complete.
And according to the saying of the man of God, and his flesh came again like the flesh of a little child, and he was clean.
Hallelujah. Stop there. And he was clean. Why? He obeyed the instruction of the prophet. Don't argue with the word of God. One of my mentors, Sumin Wugusa, said, God said it, I believe it, and that settled it. Don't argue. God said it, I believe it, and thou settled it. If I can get 1 or 2 or 3 or 10 prophet of God, I can stand and say, oh God, let this turn around. I tell you, by next week, every nation will be open up. We're going to pray that nation must open up. Students must go back to school. Offices must open up. None were open so that they would die. No, there shall be no more death in the land. And the prophet of God said, there shall be no more death in the land. No more death. We can't cry of them. No more death. We're going to speak the mind of God today. We're going to prophesy to nation today. We're going to speak to government today. As they hear the word of the Lord, things will turn around. For I know whom I believe. Hallelujah. I know whom I believe. I am preaching today so that your faith could build up. We can come together and agree together and say, oh God, this is what we desire. No fear. One of the things that the devil want to do is to plant fear on us. So when fear comes, then good night. Yet this, death does not just come. The first thing that the devil does is to give you attention. When he gives you attention, he puts it under detention. After detention, he will not kill you. When people commit suicide is this. When they put them under tension, the devil detain them in their mind and they give them direction. Don't think nobody loves you anymore. Go and kill yourself. After the direction, then death comes. Why should people commit suicide when we serve the big God? We don't serve a dead God. We serve the living God. Hallelujah. No matter you that are watching me on YouTube, you that's watching me on Instagram or Facebook, any platform you're watching me, don't die now. Hope is coming your way. I prophesy hope is coming your way. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't care whether you have no food in the house right now. Hope is coming your way.
Amen.
God's going to send help to you now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Don't think of what you're going to eat tomorrow. Some are even contemplating, well, after the lockdown in the nation, will I have job anymore? Will there be job for me? Of course. You're going to be an employer of labor. Hope is coming your way. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We're going to pray and just you that's watching me online and going to watch me later, we're going to agree together and speak to nations of the world. Speak to nations of the world. Africa must be saved. Europe must be saved. Asia must be saved.
Amen.
The Middle East must be saved.
Amen.
America must be saved.
Amen.
Brazil must be saved.
Amen.
Australia must be saved.
Amen.
Canada must be saved.
Amen.
This virus will not kill them anymore.
Amen.
We stand against that spirit called virus. We ask the spirit to go back to where it came from.
Amen.
It's dead a long time ago.
Amen.
What we're going to see this on the 1st of May, the east wind is going to blow them out of nations. Because this pandemic is dead a long time ago.
Amen.
Let us agree together and begin to pray. You that's watching me right now, agree together. If there's somebody in your house, just agree with that person. If you're alone, just agree. Come on, let's agree. An end to this virus. Kakabahaya Bakanda Lakandolo Belekon Tolobo. We believe on the word of God. We believe on the word of God. Kamelo Sule Malande Kikalamana Sire Don Tala. Yes, Lord. Enough is enough. This nonsense must stop. This nonsense must stop. People are going back to work. Mekon Tolekanahaya. Je le conto le bene canto e re sobina nanda kule me e riconda conda la bikinda e re kunko parada. Let all God faith rise up in nations of the world. Nations of the world. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We're going to pray for president of nations. The Lord, we agree together that they will take the right decision. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let's begin to pray. Say, Lord, touch every president of nations. They will take the right decision. They will take the right decision. Let our president of God take the right decision. May no consale mana. He can't tell a lavana haya. Knows all about us. scripture, we'll take one prayer and then we'll round up. I'm going to read the scripture for you in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 24. 2 Samuel chapter 24, verse 15 to 16.
2 Samuel 24.
After this, we're going to pray, then we'll round up. Hallelujah.
2 Samuel 24.
Yes. From verse 15 to 16.
From verse 15. So the Lord sent a pestilence upon Israel.
Yes.
From the morning even to the time appointed.
Mm-hmm.
And there died of the people from Dan even up to Beersheba 70,000 men.
Man.
And when the angel stretched out his hand upon Jerusalem to destroy it,
yes,
the Lord repented him of the evil and said to the angel that destroyed the people, "It is enough.
It is enough.
Stand out thy hand."
Mm.
And the angel of the Lord was by the threshing floor of Arauna the Jebusite.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The pestilence came to hit the land. 70,000 people died. And the Lord repented. Well, the one said the Lord repented. Not the one said, "I couldn't have permitted, I couldn't have allowed the devil to step into this thing." And the angel said, "It is enough. So far you go no more. No one is going to die in your family anymore."
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If you are watching me right now, no one will die in your family.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
This virus will not kill them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It is enough.
Amen.
It is enough.
Amen.
Those in the hospital right now who say death is enough.
Amen.
Nations of the world, death is enough.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's go ahead and begin to rebuke it. It is enough. 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 There shall be no death in the land anymore. It is enough. It is enough. Kekumbara de Kiyawana. Kumbarada de Ke. Those in the hospital, rise up. It's enough. It's enough. It's enough. It's enough. Can't call him a hashata. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now I want to prophesy to the nations of the world. Those in the hospital right now with this virus, I say it's enough.
Amen.
No more death.
Amen.
No more death.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And Jesus said to the man with the palsy, he said, "Rise up, take up your bed and walk." Those in the hospital watching me right now, it is enough.
Amen.
You are not going to die.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We ask for the angels to take away every pain from your body.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any sickness that's in your body before now, above on the virus, I stand as a prophet of God sent by God. That sickness dies today.
Amen.
Dies today.
Amen.
Dies today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I cause leukemia. Amen. Die in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Paralysis. Go in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Dormant death spirit. Go in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sugar diabetes. Go in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
High blood pressure. Go in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
HIV AIDS. You are a name. In the name of Jesus, every knee must bow.
Amen.
Bow right now.
Amen.
Bow right now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No more pain.
Amen.
No more sickness.
Amen.
No more pain.
Amen.
No more sickness.
Amen.
No more pain.
Amen.
No more sickness.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
We glorify your name, Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, those who are going to watch me later on this or watch me right now, if you don't know Jesus, I want to connect you to Jesus. Bible said in Romans 10:10, it said, "With the mouth we confess with how we believe that Christ died for us." Lay your right hand upon your chest and say, "Lord Jesus, have mercy upon me, Lord. I am a sinner. I come to you tonight, right now, through your mercy. Wash me clean by your blood. From today, I am a child of God. Satan, leave me alone, for I belong to Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen." Now, if you pray that prayer, I want to assure you are born again. You are a child of God. Don't let the devil deceive you. You are a child of God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit everyone that taking the decision to follow you. You that saved me as a DJ from a nightclub, you can save as many. Right now, let your salvation be permanent in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Please connect with us tomorrow. In the meantime, we're having 1 hour online prayers. And I'm going to post it on my page tonight or tomorrow morning so that you could set your alarm. We're going to pray all through tomorrow for 1 hour. Things must change. Hallelujah. God bless you for joining us for this telecast. I'll see you tomorrow and also on Sunday. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah.